If you haven't heard by now, a freelance reporter and a contributor with The Rebel, Holly Nicholas, and I were not allowed to participate in the NDP's Royalty Review press conference that was held last week. Here's Holly explaining what happened to us here.
So I showed up at the event at about 9:10 a.m. with access, granted access, with my driver's license and my media accreditation card. And I sat in the event for about 2 hours until Sheila showed up and they discovered that I was with The Rebel and I wasn't an accredited media source. So they kicked me out of the event.
Now, our story doesn't end there. After this happened, we went to ask about speaking to some of the stakeholders. And that question alone resulted in us being made to leave the entire floor of the hotel where the press conference was being held. We weren't allowed to wait with the other media that was there. We were kicked out. This resulted in us being prevented from being involved in any press scrums or completing any of our pre-arranged interviews that we had that day. We weren't rude or argumentative. We immediately complied, kicked off the floor for asking a question. Now, we were made to leave by Marcella Munro. She's the anti-pipeline activist from BC that used to lobby against Trans Mountain and the Northern Gateway Pipeline. She's here now, hired as a stakeholder relations manager for the McDougall Center. The McDougall Center is the Alberta government's Southern Alberta office. At The Rebel, we've done many stories about Munro and her activism against Alberta. And while I personally like to think Holly and I are special, Munro has a history of blocking press access to government events during her time in BC. Bob Mackin, a veteran BC reporter, tweeted at me a story about how Marcella Munro makes blocking press access a habit. Marcella used to be the spokesperson for Vision Vancouver. That's the municipal political party of Vancouver Mayor Gregor Robertson. He too is anti-oil and anti-Alberta. Mike Buda from TransLink, the Metro Vancouver Transportation Network, emailed Munro looking for advice on blocking press access. He wrote, "Bob called me asking for an interview on the lack of campaign rules from the province. I assume I will let you guys follow up. Let me know." So Munro wrote back, "I do not like engaging with him at all, but please ask him to direct his questions to our media email. I can't imagine this is something we would comment on at any rate." So they're consorting to waste Bob Mackin's time here. Bob would not be deterred though. 6 hours later, Buddha wrote to Munro, "This guy has left me 3 voicemails, a couple of emails, and now DMs on Twitter. He is asking about the contractors we have on, not about voting rules. So you want me to keep ignoring him? I should add he asked Greg about this and Greg told him to call us." Munro emailed back, "You need to trust me here, not Greg, please ignore, call me." Munro just gave a bureaucrat a clinic at stonewalling the press. So much tax dollars at work right there. But that's not all. Global News reporter Jeremy Hunka was kicked out of a TransLink press conference when Munro was running communications for Vision Vancouver. And when asked why, Munro didn't answer. She just told the reporter they could watch the live feed. This is who Marcella Munro is. She's here to minimize and strip away the ability of reporters and scrutineers like us to do our jobs. This is why the Notley government hired her. Munro has a well-known reputation for this type of behavior. She's well paid by your tax dollars to make sure you have no idea what's going on in the halls of government. $130,000 per year. Remember when Notley said she'd do things differently? She's keeping her promise. This is the kind of totalitarian message control the Redford Tories could only have dreams about. For TheRebel.media, I'm Sheila Gunn Reid.